Let's speak Korean.
제 41회 생일을 축하해.
That's what I was saying. 안녕하세요. Hello everyone and welcome to Let's Speak Korean. I'm your host Lisa Kelly and this is your guide to mastering the Korean language with just 10 minutes every day. Next to me we have our other wonderful teacher. Hi Stephen.
Hi Lisa, how you doing?
Good.
안녕하세요. I'm Stephen Revere and I will be helping teach you Korean and we also have a couple of students with us today.
안녕하세요. 저는 미리암입니다.
Mm-hmm. 안녕하세요. 저는 제이슨입니다.
Okay. Lisa, I have a question.
Yeah.
I see some, what do you, you got some stuff back here. What are the flowers for?
Stephen. What, Stephen?
Those
come
for
on.
Me?
All right. Well, thanks. Actually, today is Jason's birthday, so this is actually for you. This is from Miriam.
How did you guys know?
Yeah, I got it.
Yeah,
happy birthday. Thank you.
Yeah, happy birthday.
This is champagne. We'll open that up later. Happy birthday.
Great. 생일 축하합니다.
We're going to party with this stuff.
생일 축하합니다.
Why don't we open right now?
Oh, just a little bit later. A little bit
okay.
later. But where's the cake?
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Where's my cake?
Don't tell me you forgot.
Not to mention you ruined the surprise. No wonder. Okay.
Oops. Where's my cake?
Yeah, oops, big oops. Mm. All right, you guys take care of that. And in the meantime, we'll go take a look at Let's Do It.
Let's Do It!
어서 와.
생일을 축하해.
Okay, and we heard the very expression we were saying right before, okay? 생일 축하합니다. But before that, we heard a different expression. We said, 어서 와, 어서 와. Or sometimes we say, 어서 오세요 in the higher form. What does this mean, Stephen?
Yeah, well, you'll hear this. Something similar to this all the time. What, when you walk into a store, in right. the, what do they say to you? What's the first thing they say when you walk into a store in Korea?
어서 오세요.
어서 오세요, right? Also is kind of like, it means you want to speed something up, hurry up a little bit. But in this instance, okay, it's you're being friendly. You're saying, oh, come on in, hurry up and come on in, right? Also, 와 is something you would say to your friends. Hey, come on over, hurry up and come on over here. And then 어서 오세요 is the high form. It's much more polite. You say that to customers. And you might even hear some other versions, too.
Right. And actually, there's even a higher form than that, which is 어서 오십시오. Okay, just keep that in mind. You will hear that when you go to restaurants and other places, like department stores. Mm-hmm. And here's another one that I hear in Korea, and I love this one. I hear it in Japanese restaurants most of the time. 어서 오십시오. 어서 오십시오.
That's a different version. It's
right.
called... speaking really quickly.
Right, it's slapped together, but everyone knows what it means, and you'll most likely hear this in restaurants, okay? All right, and the other thing that we heard in the dialogue, okay, we heard, here's the big expression for today, Jason, 생일 축하해, 생일 축하해.
생일 축하해. Again, amongst friends, this is the low form, 생일 축하해. If you're going, 생일 is birthday. 축하하다 is congratulations on something. When you're congratulating somebody, you say 생일 축하해. Now, you can also make it one step higher, 생일 축하합니다. And then you can make it even more, even higher, 생일 축하드립니다. Okay, 생일 축하드립니다 means your 드리다 is to give something in the highest form, very polite. So you're just saying, I give you congratulations. You would never say 생일 축하줘요, okay? You can't use 주다, you can't use give in any other format, only that one. 생일 축하드립니다.
But Stephen, what was the word 생신? I heard that one too.
Okay, yes. That is, again, the super high form.
That's right.
Yeah, you might not hear that very often.
You actually hear it, not from your friends, but you're going to hear it when someone is speaking to their father or their grandfather or some like their boss. Okay, you don't just say happy birthday, but they have a different word altogether to refer to birthday. So you would say 생신 in that case.
So can I say 생신 축하드립니다?
Yes, you can. Mm-hmm. All you want. That's perfect. Yes, 생신 축하드립니다.
And then when you have 생일, you want to say 생일을 or 생일을. But here, usually just in speech, we don't usually say it, so you don't need to worry about that.
Yeah, no, you would never. Even the song, right?
Right.
생일 축하합니다. There's no 을 in there, is
actually,
there?
Actually, we should try that don't once. Okay, let's just do two rounds of it. Okay, one, okay. two, three.
No.
생일 축하합니다. 생일 축하합니다.
We should go one more line.
No.
사랑하는 Jason.
Okay, that's the Jason that we love is what we're saying. Yes.
Right. And you can also say, without the 생일, it just means congratulations. So it's 축하합니다. Yeah. 축하합니다. Let's try that, okay? 축하합니다.
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 And then among friends, you're just going to say 축하해. Yeah. So the next time your friend passes a test or does well on a test
right.
or has some good news, you can remember this saying, hey, 축하해.
Okay, and let's find some other things that you can congratulate people for. It's not just for your birthday, but what about a graduation? Okay, 졸업 is the word for graduation. Congratulate everybody out there for graduating.
졸업 축하드립니다.
Okay.
졸업 축하드립니다.
What if it's your friend?
졸업 축하해.
Good.
졸업 축하해. Yeah.
축하해.
졸업 축하해.
All right. 축하해. And then there's a wedding. Okay, you're congratulating friends on a wedding, which is 결혼.
결혼 축하해.
결혼 축하해.
Or 결혼 축하합니다. Okay, and then there's an admittance too. Like you could get into a college, for example, okay, which is 입학.
입학 축하해.
입학 축하해.
Yeah, you're going to start catching on, ladies and gentlemen, that some 입 means to go in somewhere, okay? 입구 is an entrance to somewhere. 입학, you know 학교 is school, don't you? You can kind of pretty this 한자 Chinese characters are actually really amazing and very scientifically set up. You can start guessing at meanings pretty quickly. 입학.
Right, that's very true. All right, now that we've built up our vocabulary, definitely we can. Let's go over those one more time. Those are expressions that we'll definitely use quite often when you're in Korea. Okay, it's your friend's wedding. Congratulate them.
결혼 축하해.
결혼 축하해.
Okay, and it's your younger sister's graduation.
졸업 축하해.
졸업 축하해.
Another one that comes to mind, since we're on Chinese characters a little bit here, you've got 결혼. Hon ends up meaning marriage, doesn't
That's it?
Right. So someone who's not married is referred to as 미혼.
Right.
Isn't that interesting
미혼,
too?
미혼.
미혼, yes, we are both 미혼. 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 We're single, right? That's the word for single.
Mm-hmm. Well, if we have single people, then you gotta mention the married people.
You wanna know? Yes. Okay. That would be 기혼, okay? 기혼. Is married people. Yeah.
Married people.
You see that on a lot of forms, right? Where you have to put whether you're married or not. You will say 미혼 or 기혼.
Good. Okay, well, I think that's enough for today. It's very simple and very clear cut. Let's go take a look at Wrap It Up.
Wrap It Up
with Lisa
and Steven.
어서 와, 스티븐.
생일 축하해, 리사.
고마워. 어서 들어와.
친구들도 같이 왔어.
그래? 어서 들어와.
야, 생일 축하해.
생일 축하해요.
Okay, we learned a lot of expressions that have to do with congratulating people not just for your birthday, but for other events as well. And here I'd like to say, Jason, 생일 축하해. 네,
고맙습니다.
Yeah, congratulations.
So what are you going to do?
You know, the age in Korea, you get, you're a year old when you're born.
Right.
And then you get another year as the Lunar New Year passes. Mm-hmm. So often you're 2 years older than you would be almost any place else in the world.
Jason, you're getting
tough
old.
To be so old, huh?
Right. So what are you going to do?
Well, actually, I was going to plan on inviting all you guys over for a party.
And I suppose you'll be paying.
On the convenient ways, right?
That's right. You'll be paying because in Korea, it's the birthday boy pays.
Okay. Nice, yes. We'll bring presents.
Yeah, we will.
All right. Well, I already gave you your presents. So.
Oh, yeah. Oops.
Oh, me too.
All right. Thank you, everyone, for joining us today. I'm sure you're taking with you some very useful expressions today. See you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, everyone.